every sci-fi film in the 1970s was Attack of the Killer Tomato. So I thought, oh, God. But we were desperate for the work. So I said, yes. So the next morning I turned up at Elstree Studios, or a week later or something like that, and to a very, very deserted Elstree Studios, apart from the big soundstage, which is now the famous soundstage there, George Lucas soundstage. And there was a big mock-up of a few things at the one end of the soundstage and a bit of the Millennium Falcon. I didn't know what it was at the time, so I went over and thought, oh, that's quite impressive. There was nobody around because it was very early in the morning, apart from one guy in the corner. I went over to him and said, oh, you couldn't get me a coffee, I'm desperate, I haven't had breakfast yet. And he went off and got me a coffee, and as he came back, I said, she don't know anything about a movie being made here. I'm supposed to see some bloke called some George. He said, I'm George Lucas. And that was how I got the job. God knows how I got the job after that. But he then gave me the job.